We know the time and the place, but where are we headed? If we asked this robot to go from its starting position to this target, what would we need to tell it? We can measure and determine that they are three rotations apart. Turning the motor three times, we could end up anywhere. The robot needs one more piece of information. What direction is it headed? We could tell the robot to move two rotations forward and then to the left for another 2 1/4 rotations. Or we could move two rotations up and 2 1/4 rotations to the right. A third option would be to use our gyroscope sensor. We can rotate the robot to a certain angle, and then we can move three rotations. Where the robot travels can be shown by vectors. Vectors are quantities that have magnitude and direction. The length or distance traveled is the magnitude, and the angle or orientation is the direction. A vector has a starting point and an end point. All these vectors have different starting and end points, but they are equivalent since they have the same magnitude and direction. This shows us that a vector isn't defined by its location. This is why we can move the vectors around. Vectors are often written in bold or with lines or arrows above them to distinguish them from scalar quantities. Scalars only have magnitude and no direction. Mass, volume, and temperature are scalars. You can add or take away the mass of an object, increase or decrease its volume, raise or lower its temperature, all without changing where it's located. Velocity, acceleration, and force are vectors. In a tug of war, the object moves in the direction of the largest pull, which is also known as a force. When swimming across the river, the velocity or swiftness of the current and how fast you're swimming will both impact where you end up on the opposite shore. Firing thrusters to decelerate or slow down your spacecraft will affect where it ends up landing. Using regular addition or subtraction does not work with vectors. When adding vectors, we have to calculate both its magnitude and its direction. Addition works by doing what my high school physics teacher dubbed vector rehab. This is just breaking the vectors into their various components. We saw this with the robot moving at the start of the video. This property of vectors is useful for adding vectors together. The components of the vector lie along the axis of the coordinate system. This means the components that are in the x-axis are all parallel to each other, and the ones on the y-axis are all parallel to each other. And parallel vectors can be added together since they are pointed in the same direction. Then you can use the sum components to calculate the resultant vector, which is just the new vector that you get from adding the original two together. This also works in three dimensions. Vectors are often defined by their components instead of their magnitude and direction. Here are three forms of notation for the same vector. With any of these notations, we can easily add or subtract the vectors. Even without equations, vectors can convey a lot of information. Just as you know these characters are moving to the right, and the top one is moving faster than the bottom one. Let's look at the world using vector vision. They can show us snapshots of what is going to happen. They can represent structures, and we can use them to balance out forces and make sure there's no movement. They simplify complex systems like airplanes. They represent movements of many individual parts, like in a hurricane, magnetic field, electric field, or how these two fields move and interact with each other. Vectors make the world around us into manageable snapshots of complex interactions. We highlight vector math and how to use sensors to determine your orientation in the next videos of this series. Thank you to Google's Making in Science team for making this video possible. Check out this playlist and the hashtag Science Goals for other Making in Science videos so you can keep exploring.